2022. I can't hear you. Much better, much better. We got a great show for you tonight. We're going to start off. Before our first skit tonight, I want to make a couple of announcements. There's a tradition on skit night that we have jokes that are told. If you would like to tell a joke on stage, come by and see Mr. Isaac over here. Tell him the joke. Make sure it's good for our stage up here, and then we'll call you up. We also have a new feature this year. If you are familiar with TikTok, you know that Duke Guthrie is on TikTok. He has tips from Duke. So we're going to do a little sample of that tonight also in between our skits. So that's something for us all to look forward to. All right. For our first performers tonight, we have Girls Cabin number 4. This is Jessica Custer, Meredith Wood, Lori Beth Taylor's cabin. This is The Process.
Hey, Hannah, what are you doing?
I am working on writing our skit because I've heard everyone around camp saying they have their skit ready. Albert has been planning this year's skit since 2001. We are so underprepared. I was just trying to get it started, but I don't know if I'm on the right track.
Oh, okay. Do you want help?
That would be great.
What do you have so far?
Well, I was thinking we could just reenact the ballroom scene from Cinderella 2, Dreams Come True.
Oh, Hannah, that is not near big enough. Do you want me to tell you some of our past skits and we can draw inspiration from those?
Oh yeah, that would be helpful.
What about an aquatic route? A bit of undersea adventure, if you will. One year, there was a skit that was pretend synchronized swimming. Let's watch a bit of it.
But I have swimmer's ear, and I don't have my goggles, so I probably shouldn't go swimming. What else do you have?
Alright then. Well, one year there was a skit about tea.
Oh, like the Boston Tea Party? I loved learning about that in school.
No, Hannah, a teapot. Here, let's look back to when I did it as a wee lass in Kevin Run.
Hey, it is way too hot to drink tea, and you and I both know that Reese is still upset that she had no spout. We don't want to make anyone sad.
Oh yeah, true about it being hot. Well, there was this one epic skit about how the Red Drake Kool-Aid went missing. It was so powerful that we got Red Drake back. Look, isn't that such a work of art?
Ha! I'm Purple Drake.
Hi, I'm Yellow Drink.
Hi, I'm Orange Drink.
Where's Red Drink?
Guys, I'm right here.
Cause we see our true colors shining through. We see your true colors. And that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors.
L-Tate. Hello? Are you there?
I'm sorry. It's just so good it mesmerizes you. Let's not do that one. There is no way we can do it justice. And anyways, we got Red Drank back after all, so let's just be thankful.
Alright then. Anyways, what else do you have?
Oh, I know. There was a skit about a candy store. That one is a classic. Watch.
What kind of candy do you have here?
Two suckers on a stick.
Nah, I had candy at canteen earlier. I'm good on candy.
Ugh, this is hard. A crowd favorite is always the eating contest, though. That one has caused a few people to almost throw up.
Chase Justin.
Oh, that sounds awesome. Let's see one from the past.
Hello, and welcome to the Camp Kalos Annual 2017 Eating Contest. Go bananas, babes!
3, 2, 1, go! Wait, serious question. Why does your camp have so many skits about food and drinks? Don't you think that's a bit strange?
Well, I mean, when you eat 6 times per day at camp, it's just a big part of the experience and deserves to be showcased in a skit.
Alright, moving on. Well, what skit did you do last year?
We don't talk about Grandpa.
Oh, I guess I asked the wrong question. Oh, hey guys. Have you been there the whole time? Is it skit night right now? Was this our skit? Well, we got that over with.
Alright, let's hear it for Girls Cabin Number 4 and the Two Suckers on a Stick. Alright, Girls Cabin Number 4, come on down.
Alright, sounds good.
Alright, while they're getting ready, you got one? Alright, come on down.
Did you hear about the tying a knot competition? It was tied up.
Who's next? Who's next? Emily Bennett.
How does a cloud dress itself? A cloud dress itself with a rainbow.
Hi. Are we ready for a tip from Duke?
He's a little gun shy.
We may try that again a little bit later, maybe. All right. Let me see if they're ready. Y'all ready to go?
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and introduce you. Does anybody need to get a mic?
I don't think so.
No mics? All right. You need a mic. Let me introduce you, and then have a seat.
All right. They tell me they are ready for us. Next performer is Boys Cabin number 4. Yeah. This is Dan Griffin, Kurt Ingram, and Cameron Cagle's Cabin. This is called Thank You.
Thank you very much.
Good evening, Camp Kalos. Let's get some noise. All right, welcome to tonight's show of The Tonight Show. I'm Jimmy Fallon, and we love camp, don't you? This is when you say yeah. All right, we just thought we'd just tell you a few things that we were really thankful for you about camp. Thank you, Melissa, for looking like a human toothpick. Thank you, Cabin 4 Boys, for having the same level of motivation about skin writing as your counselors do. Thank you, Barry, for showing us what it would look like if the Earth hit a human face. Thank you, Isaac, for looking like Sid from Toy Story. Thank you, Jess, for showing us what people must have done before megaphones. Thank you, Hot Cheetos, for apparently being a desirable personality trait for our campers. Thank you, Randy Boyd, for showing us how to use our power to get a week of vacation for free. Son, go talk to your counselor. Another job well done. Thank you, ages 11 to 13, for teaching us the true meaning of awkward. You know it's true. Thank you, Paul Hemshell. For looking like the cinnamon stick from Apple Jacks. Couldn't even get through it. Thank you, Swamp, for showing us that TikTok haircuts don't necessarily make you a bad person. Sorry, boys. Want to go back to a circus tent. Thank you, Camp Kalos kitchen staff, for showing us what true family-style food is supposed to taste like. 1, 2, 3, we love you, Cubs. Showing us what it would have looked like to live in the Great Depression.
When's our next meal?
Tuesday.
What's today?
Saturday. Thank you, G6 Skits, for showing us that eternity is a really long time. Thank you, Shelley Walden, for keeping dinosaurs away from camp before they went extinct.
Get away from my girls! She sits forever!
Thank you, Jake Guthrie, for crying literally every time you speak in public.
That's the end of our skit!
Somebody was paying attention.
All right, let's hear it from boys' cabin number 4. Looks like girls 5 is already here. We got any jokesters? Come on down.
What do you call a pig that does karate? Pork chops.
Why couldn't the bike get all the way up the hill? Because it was too tired.
Do what? Huh? Sure. Come on up.
We have a special treat tonight.
Don't hurt yourself. Please don't hurt yourself.
Wow. I would do that, but I don't want to show off or go to the hospital, so either one. Who's next?
Why was 6 afraid of 7? Because 7 ate 9.
Who's next? Who's next? Anybody? Anyone?
Where's Duke?
What did the cat say when it saw its new bed? It's perfect.
I don't know where Duke went. I'd like to. No? Oh.
All right. I got to pay attention here.
There you go. Speak up real loud.
What do you call a one-legged hippo? A hoppo.
What does a peanut butter fish go with? A jellyfish.
One more joke? All right. You got anybody else? Okay.
No, you don't. No, you don't. I got nothing. What?
Y'all ready? Okay.
All right, they tell me they're ready, thank goodness. Our next performers, Girls' Cabin number 5. This is Addison Cagle, Paige Higgins' cabin. This is A Tale of the Lost Tale.
deep in the 100 kilos woods, Winnie the Pooh awoke to the sound of his tummy growling.
Oh, bother. It seems that I'm very hungry.
So Pooh decided that he would go and find some food. On his way, he passed by a thistly corner of the forest.
Oh, bother.
It seemed that Pooh's friend Eeyore was in a bit of trouble.
Why, hello there, Eeyore. What seems to be the matter? Where do I even begin? Well, you could start with what is the matter. Well, I've been doing my mandatory physical therapy for the Earth Ball incident, wondering where it all went wrong. Then I came home and laid on the ground and stared at the sun. And then counted rocks to try and get my sight back, but I feel like I've misplaced something.
Well, let's have a look at you. Why, Eeyore, what has happened to your tail?
What has happened to it?
Well, it isn't there.
Did someone take it?
I'm not sure, but I know someone who may know where it went. He's the smartest and brightest person I've ever met.
Well, I'm positive you're not talking about me.
Let's go!
So Pooh and Eeyore traveled down the paths of the 100 Kalos Woods. As they were walking, they spotted exactly who they were looking for, the smartest animal in all of the Kalos Woods, Owl.
Oh, Owl, we were just on our way to your house.
Well, hello, Pooh. It seems that you have caught me on my way out. I just took my third shower of the day, and now I'm about to begin my fourth CrossFit workout. What seems to be the issue?
Well, Owl, you seem to have less feathers on your head than last time I saw you.
Well, with three little chicklings and one big dookie in the same nest as you, it becomes very easy to lose one's feathers.
Well, perhaps you could try working out more.
Well, I have created quite the CrossFit training regime for myself and the chicklings.
That sounds thrilling.
Owl? Eeyore seems to be missing his tail. Have you happened to see it?
Eeyore's tail? It's missing? So I see.
Will you help us, Owl? You have such a talent for speaking and telling everyone what to do.
Why, thank you, Pooh. Yes, I do, don't I? I didn't think that anyone noticed. It seems that the thing to do will be to go to each of the friends in the 100 Kalos Woods and see when they saw Eeyore's tail last.
Oh, Owl. That sounds like a marvelous idea.
It is a great idea, but it probably won't even work.
So the trio took off to Rabbit's house to see if she had seen Eeyore's tail. Now, Rabbit was a very put-together animal. You should see her basement. It is a treasure trove. Her garden was a prize-winning feature of her home. And before she went to bed each night, she emptied every dish from the sink and put them right back where they belonged. It is also said that Mr. Rabbit closely resembles the famous Mr. Bean, but he is not in our story today.
Ah, Rabbit, I see you've been working hard in the garden. I do enjoy eating healthy vegetables myself. They go lovely with the strict CrossFit workouts I have been doing.
Yes, well, I love vegetables. When I was a young rabbit, I only ate vegetables, and that's what makes me so happy all the time.
Rabbit, do you have any tacos from the bowl? These vegetables look just disgusting.
What do you mean disgusting? I've spent season after season trying to perfect these vegetables, and here you are calling them disgusting.
Rabbit, it seems we have a bigger issue here that is not healthy. Eeyore seems to have lost his tail. Have you seen it recently?
I have not, but I did see Kanga earlier with a big basket of things. Maybe she happened to find it.
Let us go and ask her then.
So the group traveled to Kenga and Roo's house in search for Eeyore's tail. When they arrived, they couldn't seem to find Kenga or Roo because of all the random stuff sitting around the hut. And Kenga blamed Roo for the mess, even though it was Kenga's stuff. Her preschool stuff.
Kenga, are you here? We seem to be in need of your help.
Oh no, is everyone okay? Where's Roo? I've lost Roo. Cursor Roo, come back to your pouch this instant.
Mom, I'm in the pouch.
Oh, good. We are good.
Kenga, where are your other children?
I'm not sure. This one's my favorite, though, so we're all good.
I wish I was the favorite.
So, what do you need help with?
Kenga, Eeyore has managed to lose his rump decor, and he cannot seem to function without it.
I've never been known to function with it.
Well, I haven't seen a tail, but I know Piglet found a bunch of knickknacks the other day.
Ooh, yes. Piglet is very clever.
So the group continued to grow and traveled to Piglet's house. During their travel...
Roo! Where did you go, Roo? Where did you go?
Mom, I'm in the pouch.
As I was saying, during their travel, the group looked far and wide to find poor Eeyore's tail as they traveled to Piglet's place. Now, Piglet was the runt of his litter. Not only was he the smallest in figure, but he was also the smallest thinker. But if you ever needed something constructed that you only use once in your life, for example, a sleigh or maybe a jeep, Piglet was the pig to do it, and he did it beautifully.
Piglet, we're here!
Oh, I must have been early.
Early for what? You live here.
Piglet, have you happened to see Eeyore's tail?
What does it look like?
Well, it's long.
Oh, I have seen it.
See, Robert? I told you Piglet was very clever.
Not quite, Piglet.
Oh, I thought that was it.
Piglet, this is a book.
Yes, I read it to me, and it was the longest tail that I had ever heard.
Not quite, Piglet. We're looking for something that can hang on the...
Aha! I do have that! Here you go!
So, this doesn't seem to be working, and it's almost Carceroo's nap time.
Mom, I'm old enough. I don't need to take naps anymore. And this pouch is super uncomfortable, anyways.
Silence! I know who can help us. Who has the longest tail in all of the 100 Kalos Woods?
I do! The deer have really long tails!
Oh, very good, Piglet. I was going to say a chipmunk.
No. Everyone knows snakes have very long tails.
Absolute nonsense! Tigger has the longest tail. It's Tigger!
Ah, yes. Tigger does live in the 100 Kalos Woods. Piglet, I believe Owl is taking all of your cleverness.
Everyone knows you already took all of mine.
So the group made their way to their last friend to see if there was any hope of finding Eeyore's tail. Now, Tigger was a former educator, but now he drives an ambulance all over the 100 Kalos Woods. Someone said, one time, somewhere, that he was even more of an accomplished rider than Owl said that he was.
Tigger, I'm so glad we found you.
My friends, I'm so glad you found me too.
Tigger, Eeyore has lost his tail and we can't seem to find it.
Can't find what? Can't find Roo? Where'd he go? Carson Roo, get back here now!
Mom, I'm still here. I don't leave the patch until mid-August. Then you're stuck with a smelly one.
Tigger, can you help us?
Does a one-legged duck swim in a circle? Does a shark ruin a family vacation? Is my middle name Ashley?
Is your middle name Ashley?
Moving on.
Tigger, please tell us you've seen Eeyore's tail somewhere.
Wait, let's circle back here. Ashley? Really?
Just then, Christopher Robin came skipping and singing along the path. Now, saying that Christopher Robin liked singing would be an understatement. Christopher Robin sang in his sleep, he sang while he was eating, he sang while he was thinking, and he even sang while he was brushing his teeth.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Christopher Robin.
Hey, Christopher Robin.
Hey, Piglet.
Wait, what are you all doing here together?
We're looking for something.
A song? I gotcha. Want something slow? Maybe a four-part harmony, and then end with an amen?
We don't need a song. We've been looking for Eeyore's tail all day. But I must say, everyone is quite weary. Except for me, because I do CrossFit daily. Sometimes more than once. Like, 2 or 3 sessions a day.
Perhaps we should take a break? I have finger foods ready at the house, and I can pull out the fine china from my basement.
That sounds like a wonderful idea. Everyone go to your homes and rest, and then we'll meet at Rabbit's for finger foods.
So everyone returned to their homes to rest. When the time came, Pooh left his home, and on the way, he heard very loud music coming from Owl's house. He decided to stop by and see what all the commotion was. As he began to knock on the door, he saw a sign that said, "Don't knock, please ring."
Ah, Pooh, come in, come in. I was just doing my mid-afternoon burpees. Don't want those finger foods going straight to my wings.
very curious.
Pooh, why do you keep staring at that bow rope? Do you like it?
I'm staring at it, Owl, because it reminds me of something. Doesn't it remind you of something, too? Maybe something we've spent all day looking for?
Well, it was just a few days ago that I found that very handsome bell rope that you seem to admire so much. It was hanging over a thistle bush. I rang it, but no one answered, and it seemed to fall right into my hand. Nobody seemed to want it, so I brought it home.
Pardon me, Owl, but somebody did seem to want it.
Really? Who?
Are you kidding me? Wow. Eeyore, he was fond of it, you see.
Fond of it? Does he have a doorbell, too?
No. He's literally attached to it. Like, literally.
Attached? Yes. Well, you see, I was just keeping it safe for him. Here, you can give that to him and tell him that he's very welcome that I found it for him.
So Pooh returned the tail to his friend Eeyore, who we think was appreciative, but it's hard to tell. Pooh spent the next few weeks avoiding contact with Owl because he knew his sarcasm would get the best of him. Pooh and Roo spent their final days together arguing over who really made the mess at home. Piglet started construction on a wooden airplane that would be used just once. Tigger spent his time planning yet another vacation to, you guessed it, Disney World. And Rabbit? Well, Rabbit was just content.
No, Pooh. You did a very important thing today.
I did?
Well, yes. Instead of thinking of your tummy, you spent the whole day thinking of your friend.
Oh, thank you, Christopher Robin.
You silly little boy.
Let's hear it for Girls' Cabin number 5. And Albert Ashley Threet. Yeah. All right. Boys' Cabin 5, or you're heading this way. So while you're getting ready, do we have any jokesters? Grady Guthrie.
What do you call a row of bunnies walking backwards?
a receding hairline.
Whoever had them in the other skit, I never got them back. There. He said they're back there.
Okay, come on up.
Why can't your nose be 12 inches long? Then I'll be a foot.
Anyone?
Have you talked to Mr. Isaac about this one?
Why didn't the dinosaur cross the road? Because roads were invented back then.
Anyone? Got any more? Anybody else over here? Nope. 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 All right. They're telling me they're ready. This is Boys Cabin number 5, Paul Hounshill, Connor Gaither's cabin. This is Church Camp Musical.
Bro, this vacation has been dope. The skiing was crazy, the food here is busting, and on top of that, some of these girls are looking modest and respectable. No cap.
I know, dude. Really, this has been so fun. But I don't know about that whole girl thing. I haven't really seen any girls so far.
Nah, bro. Check out that one modest and respectable woman. There.
Whoa. Okay. Maybe you weren't wrong. That girl over there is pretty cute. But I don't know. I'll never see her again. There's no point.
Dude, but this could be the start of something new.
Gabriella.
Troy, if you don't mind, could I get your number?
Sure.
Dude, I got her number, but I'm not sure what to send her.
I gave him my number, but he hasn't texted me yet. Do you think he's interested?
I've got the perfect idea. Send her a selfie.
Just give it time. I'm sure he'll text you.
Ah, that is a good idea.
Here, you should pose like this.
Ah, that's good. Yes!
Oh, he finally texted me. Look at it, look at it, look at it! Talking to this guy? Well, that selfie he sent is pretty weird, but I'm still gonna give him a chance.
No way! I had no clue you'd be here at camp! I can't believe it!
Same! I'm so ready for camp! Hey, you shouldn't skip with me.
Oh, definitely!
Okay, sweet. I'm so excited.
Man, I would really like to do the skit with Gabriella, but I gotta stay focused on that egg toss. The guys are really counting on me to help them out.
Bro,
breaking news, due to weather delay, the egg toss and skit have been moved to the same time. I repeat, due to weather delay, the egg toss and skit have been moved to the same time.
Wait! They're at the same time now? How am I going to do the skit with Gabriella? What am I going to do?
Come on, dude. We gotta start practicing for the big egg toss.
You're right. I gotta get my head in the game.
Hey everybody, I'm Barry and you're watching the Disney Channel. That's about right.
Wow, this week of camp has been awesome.
I know, it's been great. I just can't believe Troy came here. He's been so sweet.
Really?
Yes, earlier this week, he asked if we could hug each other. Then he wanted to take a contact picture with me. And even better, he asked if we could call me his girlfriend. Not to mention, he made a bracelet for me, too.
Oh my goodness! He sounds just like that really cool kid Max Sweet and what he did for that girl Harper Bennett.
No, I couldn't ask for better.
Isn't he going to do the skit with you?
It would mean so much to me if he could, but I'm not sure with the egg toss coming up.
Oh, man, that's such a bummer.
Let the egg tossing commence.
Wait, the rags for the feet washing afterwards are gone.
Due to the shortage of rags for the feet washing, the egg toss cannot continue. It will be postponed.
Are you kidding me? I really wanted to wash some feet! Wait, if the egg toss is postponed, I can go do the skit with Gabriella!
You know what to do, Troy. Go to Gabriella and do the skit.
I got you, Chad!
We're soaring, flying. There's not a star in heaven that we can't reach.
If we're trying, so we're breaking free.
We're breaking free.
I can't believe you made it, Troy. I thought you weren't able to. The egg toss got delayed.
Oh my goodness.
And I wouldn't want to spend my time with anybody else.
Y'all are so great together. You guys will be such a power couple.
Like Isaac and Amelia.
Or Max and Avery.
Or Connor Glasscock and Carlin.
Or Carson and Feet.
Or Barry. Oh, wait.
I'm so glad you're here this week.
Me too, Troy. But it couldn't have been as good as it was without everyone.
You know, you're right. Because we're all in this together.
Oh, it's all right.
All right, let's hear it for boys' cabin number 5 once again. Our next performers are G6. If they will come on down.
Anything over here? Anything over here?
All right, come on down.
What do you call a joke without a punchline?
Okay, that makes sense. Anyone else? To go. Looks like they're more than ready to go. This is Girls Cabin number 6, G6. This is Shelly Walden, Anna Vantrese, and Carlin Warner's Cabin. This is called 7 Girls, 4 Names.
Just kidding.
Hello. My name is Narrator. In the year 2042, we happened upon a church camp located in the woods of White Bluff, Tennessee. This camp was led by the descendants of the many camp legends of the Camp Kilos we know and love. This good and beautiful camp has been around for forever. Like, when I say forever, I mean it's old. Like, really, really old. Like as old as Barry Gibson, and then probably a little bit older. So, a recap of the camp. The mess hall, well, it burned down. It took forever to rebuild, but it has been rebuilt. And don't worry, Swamp didn't start the fire, by the way. Although, I think maybe otherwise. The cabins are still the same ones they used since the beginning of time in 1985. Camp Kalos is so rewarding and the best week of the year for literally everyone who attends. This is where our story begins. Meet our visitors, Trixie and Gizmo.
Gizmo, please put down your phone for just a minute. I don't think we are going to get a signal out here. Focus, Giz. We are on a special mission.
Wait, what do you mean special mission?
Gizmo, we came all the way from the hills of Brentwood, where the electronics have free range and the clapping sets the beat. And when it says shout to the Lord, we shout to steal the recipe for their famous Kool-Aid.
Fine, whatever. Just give me my phone back, please. I almost completed level 3,478 on Candy Crush. Hello?
We are almost to that woman for registration. We have to make sure people don't know our motives. Did you bring your hotspots?
Of course, you know I did. I brought 4 in case of a weak signal. When it comes to electronics, I'm your girl.
Excellent. I have all my best pranking gear ready as well. Let's get registered.
Let's meet up in the cabin to make a plan.
Welcome to Camp Kalos. You're going to have the best week of your life. Are you ready to meet new people?
Yeah, I guess I have everything I need in my utility belt. Crowbar, silly string, toilet paper, all the essentials for a great week.
And what about you, Gizmo?
Nah, I'm good. However, I am really thirsty.
Oh, wonderful! We have coolers of water available for you.
Yeah, but do you have anything, like, flavorful? Something fruity, perhaps?
Oh, yes. We have Kool-Aid for all of our meals.
Yes, yes. That is what I'm talking about.
Hi. I don't know you. Gizmo and Trixie. Let's see. Ah, here you are. Here are your recreation teams and color bands. The color of your wristbands is the rec team you'll be on for the week. I hope you have a great week at camp.
Oh, thanks. When is mealtime?
Oh, not for a while, but you can play some nine square or gaga ball.
We'll see.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to recreation. As my father, the great Bennett Walden, would say, hello. Today we are playing sweetheart kickball. You can hold hands if you'd like to, or hold this rope between you if your teammate has cooties. So, you will kick together, catch together, run together, smile together, be a friend together. Get it? Got it? Good.
So, what is after this exciting activity?
Well, you know, after this, we got Bible class and then lunch. I hope we're having chicken strips and toss tonight. My mama had us a cake with you, and she always raised my good memories she had with the chicken and the toss. I'm going to put some toss in my pumpkin for later. That's an idea that my daddy, Cameron Cagle, came up with. Yeah, buddy.
Okay. Who's our Bible teacher?
Excuse me, he is only the best of the best.
Welcome to Bible 101. I am Tim. You may remember me from wedding pictures. I was ironically the officiant at, yes, all of your parents' weddings. This week we will be learning how to be a part of the Lord's army.
Excuse me, what? How old are you?
Age isn't important. It's what we do with our time here on earth that is important. So, back to the Bible. We are going to learn about how we are a part of the Lord's army.
Sweet! I have some camo pants that I brought. And I can order some online for everyone if you need that, and you can just Venmo me. I just need to grab my MacBook so we can order on Amazon. Oh, and I do need my iPad to read the Bible from.
Oh, no, no. We don't need that right now, Gizmo. That isn't how we are learning today. We want to put up our electronics and bring out our paper copy of the Bible.
But my iPad.
Let's use the paper version right now.
Wait, Giz, there it is. There's the Kool-Aid. It's right there. Let's get some. Gizmo? Gizmo! Gizmo, I like how you're trying to infiltrate the campers, making friends, etc. Nice. But look. How are we going to get that Kool-Aid pitcher to analyze the ingredient?
What did you say? I can't even believe how delicious these cookies are. Have you even tried them?
I feel like you're forgetting our mission.
I think I'm in love.
What is even happening right now? Let's meet in the craft cabin so we can chat about how to steal the Kool-Aid recipe.
What? Oh, yeah, sure. Whatever. See you there.
Hi, I'm so excited to have these crafts. My grandmother, Jill Young, was famous around these parts. She taught me and my dad, Asa, how to make these picture frames with, wait for it, dry macaroni pasta shells!
What? Dry pasta? Hard pass.
What? That's amazing! I can't wait.
Gizmo, you don't even need a picture frame. You have all the pictures on your phone. What about our mission?
Trixie, could you just for once have fun? I love making crafts and I love food. This is combining the two and you are totally ruining it for me.
Fine, I'll do it myself.
Hi, Trixie. You seem upset. Want to grab a snack really fast at canteen?
Who are you?
Oh, silly of me. I'm Maxine, daughter of the great and well-known Max Thweet. Maybe you know my grandfather, Sir Albert Ashley Thweet II. He was just dubbed a sir by the Queen for his Lifetime Achievement Award for attending the Walt Disney World Parks in Orlando, Florida. He and Pat Pickens are currently working on a portal that will take him from his house directly to Disney World in under 60 seconds. They only have the macaroni prototype, but it's going to be awesome.
What is it with you guys and macaroni?
Here, have a Snickers. You seem upset.
No!
Hey there, Trixie. What's up?
Oh, Mr. Tim. You startled me. What are you doing in here?
I could ask you the same question.
What do you mean?
Well, Trixie, this isn't my first rodeo, or my second rodeo. It's not even my 30th rodeo. I knew from the minute we met that you were up to something. Let me ask you this. Why? Why are you here? Why do you want this Kool-Aid recipe so much? What will it bring to you? Happiness? Gratitude? Your friend Gizmo has embraced this camp lifestyle. What is keeping you from having fun and growing with all of us?
You know, Mr. Tim, it's me. I am keeping myself from having fun. I've been so focused on getting this silly Kool-Aid recipe and trying to steal it to take from my home camp.
Trixie, Trixie, Trixie. We all use the same camp. And even then, there is store-bought packets of Kool-Aid. You can get them at the Dixon Walmart. Can't miss it. It's the only one.
Wow. Mr. Tim, when you put it that way, it makes sense. I guess I will have to go and have some fun here at Camp Kalos. And maybe it will start something. Like a choreographed choreography number.
I'm
Let's hear it for G6. And if, in case you were wondering, Tim Frizzell will look exactly the same in 2044 as he does tonight. So things haven't changed a bit. All right, next performers, Swamp 37. Bring them on down.
Okay, I was talking to my dad the other day, and he had two burn marks on his cheek. He had two burn marks on his cheek, and I said, "Dad, what happened? You know, how'd this happen?" He said, "Well, I was ironing clothes when I heard the phone ring, so I answered." And I said, "Well, how'd you get the other one?" He said, "Well, I tried to call him back."
These, do you? Y'all don't need these.
What did two strangers say to each other? Nothing. They did not know each other.
That wasn't an ant. What was it? cricket.
All right.
Where did the gold coin to the gold coin? Hey, you.
Wow.
A chemistry joke. I like it.
Okay, guys, let me give you a quick little history lesson. Let's talk about Gandhi really quick. So some things about Gandhi. He traveled around a lot to teach some people, and, you know, he didn't really wear shoes. You know, he was very poor. He was also a vegetarian. You know, he didn't believe in violence, and so he was, like, very frail, very weak, and honestly, he didn't have great hygiene. He had really bad breath. He was a super calloused, fragile mystic hexed with halitosis.
We went a long way for that one. That was good, though. Wasn't sure where that one was going. To go. Here it is, Boys Cabin number 6, Swamp 37, Albert Thweet, Connor Glasscock's cabin. This is called Musical Dreams.
Hey, can you hear me out there? Let me introduce myself. I'm 9 years old and my name is Michael S. Bottoms. Please don't focus too much on the last name. You can just call me Mikey like everyone else. Can you see me? I'm right in front of you. No, not that one. That's my dad, who's way too obsessed with the neighbors.
Hey, you kids, get off my lawn.
And that's my mom, pretending to read the newspaper while secretly looking at her childhood crush. I don't know, some pilot guy.
Mikey! Time to wake up and get ready to go!
That's our dog beside her. Mom named him Maverick, for some reason. And that's my older brother, Billy. He's my hero, and I want to be just like him. But I'm not sure he feels the exact same way about me.
Hey, get up, loser!
Yep, that's me asleep on the bed, getting my last nap in before we head off to Camp Caleb's. It's my first year and I can't wait. But I'm even more excited for Billy. He gets to be in Swamp. You see, that's why I want to be just like him. Because he might get the chance to fulfill my ultimate dream. What is it, you ask? To be the star in a Swamp musical.
Safely on the
To Camp Kalos. All first-time campers over here for my award-winning tour.
Hey, watch it, what?
Sorry, Billy. I'm just so excited to be here. Aren't you super excited about being in Swamp and possibly starring in your musical?
Yeah, I guess, whatever. Look, I don't even know if Swamp is doing a musical this year. Just stay out of my way, Mikey. Let me do my Swamp thing, and you just stay over there in your rookie club.
Okay, I'm missing a Mr. Bottoms? Michael S. Bottoms, are you here?
Oh, that's me, sir. Mikey. Call me Mikey, please.
Okay, Mikey. Glad you could join us. Let's start the tour. Follow me. That is our mess hall. Brand new, state-of-the-art. The old one got burned down. I mean, we don't know how it happened. Over there is the craft shack where you'll do crafts every day. One word of advice? Don't mess with the craft ladies. They'll eat you for dinner. There's the ball field where you'll do recreation and organized foolishness. I used to be in charge of organized foolishness, but it was all foolishness and no organized. There's your cabins, the bathhouse, the snack shack, blah, blah, blah. You'll figure it out. But this is the amphitheater. This is the place where the magic happens. This is the stage where one day I will star in a Swamp musical. Michael Bottoms. Just Mikey, sir. Right, can you stop spinning around and join the group again? As I was saying, this is a very special place because it's where I shine. I am the MC of both skit nights, and I tell incredible jokes that everyone just loves. I remember the first time I told a joke on this stage. Oh, well, more on that later. Campers, let me introduce you to your director, Mr. Isaac.
And you are?
Mikey, sir. It's an honor to meet you, sir.
Ah, yes, Mikey Bottoms, brother Billy Bottoms, right?
Yes, sir, but you don't have to yell our last name, sir.
Right. Well, it's good to have you here for your first year of camp.
Thank you, sir. I'm super excited to be here. This is a great camp. I don't know how you do it.
Do what, Mikey Bottoms?
Just Mikey, sir. And I don't know how you run a camp with so many moving parts. I mean, the kitchen staff, the counselors, all the campers, the temperamental craft ladies, Barry. I mean, how do you do it, sir? How do you handle all that pressure?
I'm the strong. I'm not good. Miss us. The ghost is.
Okay.
I'm in the church, and I broke my birthdays.
Shouldn't we be getting that?
I don't ask how they work it. I don't offer this perfect. I'm handy. What's that? They're circus. You're the circus. Don't want it. They're in circus. They're in circus. Circus. I got it.
Oh,
Swamp 37, wear that name with pride and honor. Blah, blah, leadership, blah, blah, example. Okay, let's talk skit. This is why you're here. We will be working on the skit during FOB, free time, before Rise and Shine, after ball field, and secretly with signals during Sing and Be Happy. You will eat, sleep, and breathe the Swamp skit. You will be allowed 1 hour of sleep per night, but you should be dreaming of the skit during that time. And one of you... will be the star of this year's epic musical masterpiece. Here are your scripts. Have them memorized in 1 hour, and clean up this dump.
Man, this is ridiculous.
No kidding. I mean, I love being in Swamp, but this is too much, right?
Definitely too much. Wait, what's too much?
This skit. I mean, this script even says volume 1 of 3.
Too much math for me.
Hey, Billy, how about you, man? What do you think about all this?
I'll tell you what I think.
It's a hard knock life. It's a hard knock life.
You'll work on this skit till it shines like the top of the mess hall!
It's hard not to-
Wow, that was great!
Mikey, you little punk. What do you think you're doing?
I was going to the creek. I thought the creek was in here.
No, you didn't, you little spy.
Hey, Billy, is this your little brother?
Unfortunately, but it's about to be my little injured brother.
No, wait! I'm sorry. I just couldn't resist watching the amazing Swamp rehearse for their skit. Can I watch? Huh? Can I?
Yeah, you can watch. You can watch my fist as it meets your face.
Come on, Billy, please. The Swamp skit is the greatest thing ever. I mean, I dream of one day being the star. In fact, do you think I could maybe just possibly have a small part this year? You know, like a surprise cameo? That would be a big hit.
Yeah, speaking of big hits.
Hold up, Billy. Hey, kid, it's nice that you like our skit, but we can't let you in.
But he's already in here.
Yeah.
I mean in the skit, you goons.
Besides, what makes you think you're a Swamp skit material anyways, kid?
Well...
that's enough.
One, two.
He's not Swamp and he's leaving. Now.
I'm sorry, I didn't see you.
Well, no, you wouldn't with your head down, silly. hello? You there? What's wrong? You look sad and a little creepy.
Yeah, sorry. My brother just threw me out of the swamp. I just want to be a part of their skit so bad.
Yeah, I understand being left out. Whole cabin is ignoring me. I'm Sally, by the way.
I'm Mikey. Is this your first year too?
Sure is. And I don't know anyone. Well, except for you now, Mikey. What's your last name?
We'll get to that later. Say, Sally, do you believe in love at first sight?
I don't know. Maybe.
Well, will you go to friends night with me?
I don't know. Maybe. I mean, Mikey, we just met. Isn't that a little unusual?
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. Or when I see you hanging about with anyone.
Guys, this is a disaster. Our skit is absolutely nowhere near ready. You two look like marionette puppets that got electrocuted. And are you two supposed to be girls or the monsters from Stranger Things? Because I can't tell. And Billy, you're supposed to be the lead and our star choreographer, but it looks like your toes got amputated last night. Why can't you guys get it together? Our skit is supposed to be the best.
Relax, man. We got time. We'll figure it out.
Figure it out? You're all just gonna figure it out? Really? Do you not realize that our skit is tomorrow night?
Wait, I thought it was on Thursday.
Yeah, it is. That's tomorrow.
But today is Wednesday.
Yes, it is. That makes tomorrow Thursday. Are you guys sharing a brain? Hey, Connor, what are you saying? I'm saying I'm done, and you guys have got to fix this quick. Get some help. Find someone else who's more talented, whatever. The point is, you only have one more day to figure this thing out.
Really? One more day?
Yes. One day more.
One day more. Another day of destiny. This never-ending road to Calvary. These men who seem to know my crime will surely come a second time. One day more.
The day that lives until today.
Can I live when we are parted? One day more.
Tomorrow you are so hard. And yes, with you my world has started.
One more day of my life.
Never saw me.
Kid.
Yeah, hurt him instead.
Just not too hard. I bruise like a peach.
Billy, he's actually good. And you know we need the help right now. After all, Connor said...
I don't care what Connor said. He's leaving now before he regrets it.
Come on, Billy, please. They want me here.
They don't know what they want. They're idiots.
Hey, we're not idiots.
Well, we're not.
Billy, just give me a chance.
Okay, I'll give you a chance. I'll give you one more chance to get out of here for good before I tell them all what your real name is.
You wouldn't.
I thought his name was Mikey.
I bet his real name is Michael, then.
Of course it's Michael, you lame brain. I'm talking about his middle name, Michael S. Bottoms.
Billy, no!
What's the S?
Yeah, what do you mean?
Billy, don't!
Then get out.
Billy, but Billy, please! I just want a
Get
chance
Get out
to-
of here, Seymour!
Seymour?
Oh, no.
Is that really what the S stands for?
Wait, your name is Seymour Bottoms?
Even I know that's funny.
Why?
I said, get out.
You're pretty hard on your brother, man.
Yeah, Billy. He's just a kid. And it's his first year. Take it easy.
Sounds like he's got it bad enough already.
True story. You might think about that, Billy Bottoms.
Hey, Seymour.
Oh, great. You know now, too.
I was watching. I think it's cute.
Yeah, right.
Hey, you want to know my last name?
Whatever.
Well, it's Mander. How's that?
Sally Mander? Seriously?
Seriously. So, you see, I get teased just as much as you do.
Wait, really? You do?
All the time. Actually, Mikey, you're the only one that's really talked to me this whole week. Why do we always get picked on?
I don't know. Life is hard and unfair sometimes, but at least we have each other.
Thanks, Mikey.
Hey, call me Seymour.
Take my Kleenex, wipe that red stick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. Now things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly see more standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly see more understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy
Dude, you're the man.
You are the man.
And she's a woman.
Right. But Seymour, Mikey, whatever it is, doesn't matter. You killed that song.
And you too, what was your name?
Sally. Sally Mander.
Yeah, okay, Sally Mander. Who cares? You both rocked it.
Billy, dude, you can't deny it. They both got some chops.
You mean they know karate too?
How are you conscious? It means they can sing. Billy, you gotta let them do something in our skit. Them?
Us?
Both of us?
Yeah.
Why not?
Well, I'm up for it.
And I'm down for it.
What do you say, Billy?
Come on, Billy.
Billy, I'm sorry I embarrassed you. It's just, I really want to be in the skit. And it's not just because it's my ultimate dream. Don't you see, Billy? The reason it's my dream and the reason I want it so badly is because I get to be in it with you. And you're my hero, Billy.
Fine. If you care enough to make up that sappy garbage, I'll let you be in one song. But that's it.
Fine. I'll take it. Thanks, Billy. You're the best.
You're welcome, Seymour.
So what's the song? What do? What's my part?
You tell me, kid. Show us what you got.
Yeah. for Swamp 37! And for all of our performers tonight, hope you enjoyed the show. That's our show for tonight. For our campers and people here at camp, it's time for canteen. And ask that you stay around in there a little longer than usual. We have doing something a little different tonight, right? Okay, ball field's a little different tonight, so stay around the mess hall. So, driving home, drive safely. Good night.